Greetings all, Shane Bruce, Restomod Daisy. And today we're gonna conduct a class. We're gonna call this Daisy Defender 101. We're not gonna deal with the original Daisy Defender, the Model 140, because sadly we do not have one of those in Remuda here at Restomod Daisy at the development facility. But we do have a receiver for a Daisy Model 141 Defender that does not have all its accoutrement, doesn't have a stock forend or a buttstock. And we also have a complete Daisy Model 142, which is the follow-on model to the 141, which are the descendants of the original Model 140. Now, why in the world would we talk about not very common at all Daisy product? Well, I'll tell you why, because I've gotten a lot of inquiries lately over at the both Instagram account and on our YouTube channel about issues that people are currently having with Daisy 141s. And those issues revolve mostly around trying to find replacement seals for the plunger assembly and for the abutment seal. So the question that has been recurring is, what size seal does one use for one's Daisy Defender? Well, it's a wide body Daisy. The first wide body Daisies were the 140s, 141s, and 142s. And they in turn were produced over the years as a variety of other guns, the Model 99, the Model 96, the Model 97, the Model 98, I believe, was a wide body. But all wide bodies have one thing in common, and that is they use the seal sets that were common to Daisy guns from earlier years. The compression chambers in these guns are sized for, .81 inch or 13/16 of an inch. The small chamber Daisies and the small seal sets will work on them. Now, further confusion abounds because Daisy, when you call them up and ask them, do you have any seals for a Model 141, is going to tell you, no, we don't have any seals for that gun because that's a discontinued model. We quit making those in 1955. We haven't had parts for them since probably 1956. And they're right. They haven't got a bag of parts at Daisy right now that says for the 141, 142. But they do have parts for the current model, Model 25, which is a small plunger Daisy. You can tell a small plunger Daisy by the diameter. There are two sizes of seals and seal sets you can buy from Daisy. One is for the current production Red Ryder, and this one is for the current production Model 25. And as you can see, if you've got a micrometer, Mike set it about 0.812, somewhere in that range. That will fit the Model 25. This plunger assembly, is sized for the Red Ryder, and it mics out at 0.892, 0.893, somewhere in that range. So what you have is a small plunger and a big plunger. The big plungers for the Red Ryder, the small plungers for the Daisy Model 25. But miracle of miracles, mystery of mystery, it's always, it's also the same size as the plunger for the Model 11140, the old leather plungers. So if you've got a 141 and you don't want to mess with reinstalling leather plungers on your gun, you can swap it out for a Model 25 plunger assembly. Now, the old plungers, these bad boys, the air tubes, are a tapered steel plug with a metal washer that is sized to fit on a specific spot on the plunger assembly. So it'll slide down X far, typically the diameter of the leather seal that it backs, and will go no further. The air tube assembly itself is a combination of an air tube and a cap that is pinned, soldered to the face of the plunger head itself. The problem with these guys, and this one is representative of, if you can see that play, maybe you can, maybe you can't, but it's got a little wobble in it. That means it's getting worn. And if it's getting worn, it means it's gonna bust. Now this one is good and solid. So that one hasn't had a lot of time and firing cycles. So it's still a good plunger, probably live for a long time. Probably not, because if it's wiggly, that means it's already weakened. If you can rotate lightly, and this one can, it's probably going to suffer a failure at some point in time and wind up in a shot tube, wind up broke, and you'll have to replace it. So that is the style of seals that you'll have to put in your 141. Now there's another issue involved. If you go to replace one of these plunger assemblies, if you'll look at the plunger here, this assembly is set up for one of the leather seal plungers. You'll notice that the spring goes all the way to the back of the plunger assembly itself and bears on this metal washer. That's what the spring actually pushes against in the older design. The pin that holds the assembly in place is only as wide as the plunger assembly itself. You can see it in there. See that little pin? Now, on the new style system, what you've got is a foam or felt washer, a through pin that goes through the body of the plunger assembly and sticks out either side. See that? That little piece of metal there is what's holding the spring in place. So, when you're calculating, another question is the length of the air tube. But as you can see from this air tube from a 141 and this air tube from some other kind of Daisy, in terms of length of the air tube, from the face of the seal to the end of the tip of the tube, virtually the same length. So there shouldn't be any issues with occluding the BB loading port on your shot tube if you replace the leather seal system with the synthetic seal system. The length of the air tube is about the same as far as what the shot tube's going to see, because there'll be an abutment washer here, and then a little bit of the shot tube assembly, and then up here somewhere will be the feed ramp. So occluding your BB feeding slot by swapping out the air tubes, modern air tube for old air tube, should not be an issue. I haven't had any problem with that in the number one 1140s that I've converted. I have not converted a 141 or 142, although these are slated for Restomodding. We're going to be doing some interesting things with this gun, at least, and possibly this gun as well. That'll be one of the first times that I've actually used walnut on one of my builds, and we're going to try to simulate the look on this gun to resemble a Russian contract Winchester model 1895. So we'll have a full-length wood with a top cover. We will not occlude the data plate, as terribly invisible as it is. It's still kind of important to be able to see. And these will be fire blued, as most Restomod products are. But we're going to go for a Winchester 95 Russian contract look with this. More of a musket-looking lever action. So that is today's lesson on Daisy 141 Defenders, the kinds of seals you can use in them, if you're fortunate enough to have one. It's a pretty rare bird. And what are the methods and techniques you can use to get the gun up and running again? That's all for today. This is Shane Bruce with Restomod Daisy, signing off.